Hello, my name is Vincent Nememana, and this is Mikla Life, your life in fullness. Known for slogans like People First, The Change You Can Trust, General Grigori Mugishamuntu is one of the presidential candidates who are moving across the nation with the message of change.
Please, life is very, very complicated. You can be fearing one side now because you want to preserve yourselves. And change happens.
He has been able to formulate a slogan, The Change You Can Trust, and his party can only be defined as a value-driven organization with systematic leaders who want to change our country and turn it into a value-based nation. The core message of General Muntu and his ANT can be understood from his website or from the website of the political party in these words. The Alliance is a people-centered, value-based party that believes in the institutionalization of political processes as a key to unlocking democracy in Uganda. Because you cannot give what you do not have, we are committed to not only talking about our beliefs, but practicing them internally.
Change is a constant. It will happen. Change will happen. That has never been any of my worries. My main worry is the nature of change. Because one, we would hope to have peaceful change. But most important, that it needs to be qualitative change. Because we need to break out of the cycle of 58 years of having regimes come and go, come and go. And the character of the regime remains the same.
These guys have managed to sell this message of value-driven leaders, systems, and institutions across the globe. Ask any man about Muntu and he will tell you he's the gentleman who is the change you can trust.
Our politics has been marred by dirty approaches. So the coming of the Alliance for National Transformation is a welcome move in that it is going to provide a corporate approach to politics.
But that is just the description of who they are. But the question is General Mugishamuntu indeed the real change you can trust? As always, I encourage you to look at that subscribe button, hit it if you haven't subscribed yet, and make sure you are part of this community. Even hit on the bell icon that shows there after as well, so you never miss any notifications that are reminding you of the newest videos that I have posted on this channel. Now, let's get right into it. Whenever asked about this change you can trust thing, General Muntu quickly replies and says, examine our track record.
Discipline is at the core of the turnaround of what is gone wrong in our country, whether in economic terms, whether in political terms. So those Ugandans who want qualitative change, look for people who are disciplined. Because you can have one indisciplined group get out, and then you get another indisciplined group get in. And that's why we are positioning ourselves as Alliance for National Transformation, because what we offer is qualitative change, because we are a value-driven organization. And we really hope that Ugandans will understand that, and therefore put trust in us.
Since we are not God, we cannot tell the future and how much we should really trust Him. But examining the past data and His past history can really give us a glimpse into who Muntu is and if we should trust Him. Now, today, let's explore this deeply and see where to press Him. Let's examine His past actions, His past leadership, His past ways, and see if He has been the change you can trust. Now, to understand this message easily and nicely, I have tried to organize it in four parts. In part one, we are going to look at Muntu's life, his birth, his growth, his education, and who exactly he was. And then in part two, we are going to look at Muntu joining National Resistance Army in the bush. And then in part three, we are going to look at Muntu actually leaving National Resistance Army or movement and joining opposition, to be exact, FDC. And then in the last part, which is part four, we are going to look at Muntu leaving FDC and forming his own party, the Alliance for National Transformation, in 2019. My name is Vincent Nememana, and this is Mikla Life, and you are going to have a good time. Now, as always, every video that I share here on my YouTube channel, there is always an article and a PDF version of it at my website www.namevix.com. Therefore, even this same video, this same message, you can go to my website and you'll find there the full PDF, the full article with all the links and evidence that I would love you to look at and cross-examine and see for yourself. Now, let's get into this. We first examine the first chapter, the first part, which is Muntu's life, growth and education. Grigori Mugisha Muntu was born on 7th of October 1958 at Kitunga village in present-day Ntungamo district. Of course, that is in western Uganda. His parents were Enoch Karuzima Muntuyela and Ida Matama Muntuyela. Apparently, Muntu must have had a fairly good childhood life since his staunch UPC supporter father was even a big person in Ankole Kingdom. So, in one way to say it, is like Muntu had almost everything that he wanted to have in his childhood. Muntuyela was a minister in the Ankole Kingdom. Rumors have it that actually he wanted to even become a member of parliament in the 1971 general elections, the elections that were swatted by Idi Amin's coup d'etat of Obote's regime, sending Muntu's father into exile in Nairobi, where he died in 1977. When Obote took power again in 1980, he called for the remains of his friend Muntuyela to come and be buried in Ntungamo. Now, Muntuyela was buried in Ntungamo, and the school, Kitunga High School, was renamed Muntuyela High School in respect or in honor of Muntuyela, the guy who was a staunch supporter of UPC and Militoni's regime. Muntu's mother, who is Ida Matama Muntuyela, was born in 1933 and married Muntuyela in 1953. Now, they both had four children, who are Jennifer Muntuyela, Flavia Kobusinge, Mugisha Muntu, and the elder brother Herbert Nwagaba. The mother succumbed to pneumonia in February 2010 and was gracefully laid to rest on 13th February 2010. Herbert Nwagaba Muntuyela was one time an MP in NRM's government, that is in 2005, and is a strong supporter of NRM. You can see the jeopardy of Mugisha Muntu. He comes from a family. The father of Muntu was a strong supporter of UPC. And you can see the brothers, actually the older brother of Mugisha Muntu, is a strong supporter of NRM. So Mugisha Muntu is like an old man out from that family. And going back to his life, we can see that from P1 to P2, General Muntu attended Mbarara Junior School. Of course, his father was still in the Ankole Kingdom as a leader, and of course Muntu must have been in town and therefore attending Mbarara Junior School. For P3 to P7, General Muntu attended Kitunga Primary School. Now that is village, that is at home in Ntungamo, and then Kitunga High School, the school I've told you was later named Muntuyela in honor of his father, who was a strong supporter of Obote or Milton Obote. For A level, he attended Makerere College School, and for university, he attended, of course, Makerere University and did political science. That is between 1979 to 1981. While at the university, reports say General Muntu was actually a leader of Students' Union. And in his time, as people give testimonies, reviews about him, he was a great leader who was honorable and very disciplined and very principled. Muntu married Julia Kakonge in 1992, and they have two children, Ankunda Muntu, born in 1993, and Mukama Muntu, born in 1996. Muntu's wife is a daughter to John Kakonge, the 1960s and 1970s staunch supporters of UPC, by the way, who was later murdered by Idi Amin when he took over power and spotted him as one of those guys who were for UPC, and thereafter the guy was actually killed, by the way, a bloody death, crushed by a hammer in Makindye prison. Now, Julia is also a sister to Leo Chanda, who currently is a major general in Uganda's UPDF. So that is Muntu's wife. She is a master's degree in arts and sociology of development, that is University of Essex, England, master's in business administration, that is Maastricht School of Management, Netherlands, and bachelor in political science and women's studies, the University of Ottawa, Canada. According to her LinkedIn profile, she specializes in international development, especially for Africa, a mission she accomplishes mostly through the African Development Bank. Her digital footprint is as low as possible, irrespective of how big her CV is, you have heard. Even for her children, Ankunda Muntu, born in 1993, and Bukama Muntu, 1996, both children have a very minimum digital print. Getting anything about them is very hard on the internet. I tried to get something. I'll come back to it if it is necessary. While Muntu was at the university, he met Jim Muwes and other like-minded thinkers who influenced him politically and in terms of thinking. Realizing how Obote's government of the 1980s was very harsh and brutal to people, Muntu's political mind started changing drastically from his family of the UPC strong supporters to thinking otherwise. Now, here is the drama. When Muntu finished his course at Makerere University in 1981, instead of grabbing an official job to become a presidential aide for Milton Obote, his father had secured that job for him. The guy went straight to the bush to join General Museveni and his NRA guys who were already in the bush. All right, now that is the turning point. The point here is, Muntu's joining of NRA in 1981 had nothing to do with luck or with anything, because his family was strong, he had everything. His joining was based on political ideology and seeing that the Milton Obote's government of those days wasn't cool anyway. So he joined the NRA to bring the change you can trust. So based on the evidences, really, the joining of NRA wasn't based on any other external thing, but on the political ideology and the values that Muntu really stood for. Values which he had started with while at school, and values which he had maintained while studying, even in his leading fellow students at the university. Now, in the next part, we are going to look at the events that followed when he had just joined NRA in 1981. So, considering this first part, is General Mugisha Muntu the guy whose change you really should trust? My answer is a very big yes, and for three reasons. Number one, his life was characterized by humility. He was taught that lesson by his mom in his early age, and according to the reviews and everything around him, he has kept it. He's a guy who is not pushed forward to misbehave because of power and strength and the background and all of that. The mom made sure of that by telling him to not take shoes at school when they later changed to the village school. And this lesson has really made him to the guy who he is. He is humble. So if a leader is humble and cannot use his position or his background, which is strong, to influence others, but stands for truth and wants you to decide if you really want to agree with him, then that's a good leader whose change we should trust. Number two is, during his lifetime in schools as a student leader, according to reviews and what we have seen, he was a good leader, principled, disciplined, and delivering according to his word or promises. So this fact is enough to convince us that he's a guy whose change we really should trust. Number three, and the most important, is that when he joined the NRA in 1981, it was purely because of his stand for truth. He had everything at home, coming from a background of UPC guys. His job was very well assured, and he had finished his studies. So what else was remaining? Nothing. but because of his stand, his political ideology, his stand for truth, seeing what was happening in the then Obote's regime, people dying, injustice and all of that, he stood up and joined the hard side and had to forsake the father's UPC, to forsake the new job, to forsake everything that his family stood for, and was an odd man out just for truth. So is General Mugisha Muntu the real change you can trust? According to this part one which we have explored, the answer is a very big yes. So in the next part, in part two, we shall deeply explore his life in NRA during the war in the bush and even after the war 1986 and upwards in the NRA government. And we shall see his life, his thoughts, his actions. Do they convince us? Are they characteristics of a leader we can trust? Thank you so much for keeping it Mikla Life YouTube channel. My name is Vincent Nememan and this is Mikla Life. God bless you. Ciao, ciao.